do some vlogging, Mom?
Yeah, I'm doing it now.
Oh, it's my birthday.
Tomorrow is Stella's birthday.
I'm going to be...
These are her last hours.
I'm going to be in lockdown.
Seven. I know. It's a bummer. We got put into lockdown the week
I wish my birthday was on Wednesday.
Yeah, I know.
Because that was the day before that.
I promise we'll make up for it somehow. We'll make it up to you. It's getting dark so early again. Here we are at this point in the year.
Look at that.
But the walks.
Look, that looks really gorgeous. Creepy.
There's fog's coming off the river. You can't really see it when I film, but it kind of, yeah, looks sticky.
Just capturing Stella's last few steps as a 7 year old.
To start the rebuilding of life, the roads that lay open are many. When the old one's gone under the knife, and I can't.
I just checked the news and saw that Biden has secured Pennsylvania. So we are all smiles.
Such a relief.
Yeah, I knew you didn't want to have those. He came in saying he only wanted pasta till we pulled out the tater skins.
Stella, 7 year old for only about, well, technically you were born at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Tomorrow is the 8th, and tomorrow is your birthday, your magic birthday, because you turn.
8 on the 8.
Yes.
And I was 8 pounds at 8 p.m.
Very, very lucky, lucky girl. Oh, and there is just some cordial. At the age of 7, what's your favorite food?
Pasta.
Yeah, I think it had to be. Most of the year it was pasta with butter and parmesan. What's your favorite ice cream flavor?
Cookie dough or caramel.
What's your favorite movie?
Or mint.
Yeah, he's right, Mint.
Zombies and Zombies 1 and Zombies 2. I also really like Journey to the Center of the Earth.
That's been your favorite since you were 3. What's your favorite place you've ever lived?
Paris. LA.
What's your favorite book that you've read so far? Diary of a Wimpy Kid.
I've read all of them.
Yeah, is that kind of your favorite series of books?
Uh-huh, I've read every single one of them.
And
but they're kind of too easy for me.
What are some of the things you'll remember most about this year?
Coronavirus.
Yeah, other than that though.
And a bad year.
Was it a bad year?
It was one of the worst years of my life.
Oh. Well, you didn't have to go to school. Yeah, I felt like you really liked that.
Oh yeah. I always remember Zoom.
Zooming. What about the summer in the States?
My favorite thing was going to Oregon in the motorhome.
The favorite part I really like.
What'd you like?
I like the four-wheelers and the tube.
Yeah, the cabin was pretty epic.
No, actually, I like the cabin better.
I like the crawdads.
Of course you do. Oh. What were some things that you were proud of accomplishing this year? Back walkover?
Any new sports?
Tennis. I have a good one.
Okay.
What do you want to have for your birthday?
Skateboard.
And now you want to have a dog.
I do too. I've been wanting a dog my whole life.
Right. So that will come when it's time.
I think you can have a cat or a dog. Which one do you want to have?
Dog.
Well, who's allergic to cats in this family? So that wouldn't be a good idea.
And Evan.
Who do you look up to right now? Like what person in...
Evan.
Oh, that's sweet.
Stella, you know what Pokemon Snake, you know. It's not the Cobra one, but...
Higgins?
Yes!
What do you love to do?
I like to play tennis, gymnastics, dance,
yes,
sing, art.
What would you like to be when you grow up?
Performer. Actor, singer, dancer, whatever.
Where do you want to live when you're doing that? London, New York, LA?
Beverly Hills. I was born there. That's my hometown.
What's your favorite lesson at school?
Math.
What favorite?
Math and computing.
No. Mm-hmm. What favorite? Dance you like that L.
The whoa.
So, who's your favorite YouTuber?
Oh, Dante Yen.
Say it again.
Dan TDM. A fun fact about Dan TDM. His birthday is actually the same day as mine, so right. His birthday's tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly. You'll have to wish him a happy birthday on his YouTube channel. And who loves you more than anything on this planet?
You.
Who else?
Daddy.
Who else?
Alfie.
Who else?
Evan.
You can't forget Donna.
21 minutes until I'm 8.
Yep, you get to stay up until the clock strikes midnight.
That's like a tradition.
We're hanging out. I'm making your birthday cake.
Mm-hmm. And it smells so good.
And it's fun to make. I love making your birthday cake. And I'm just loving you in all your 7 years. And soon it will be my 8-year-old.
Last 7-year-old cake.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Stella. Happy birthday to you. Yay, Stella! 8 years old. I love you.
Panthers Joe.
It's Sunday morning, the 8th of November, and we are up blowing up balloons and trying to get the decorations up before Stella wakes up. I have her favorite donuts in the oven. We have some fun things in store today. We got balloons going on. I always made Evan candy cakes, like cakes with candy coming out of it. So she kept saying that she wanted something like that. She hasn't mentioned it in a bit, but I hung on to that.
Oh, wow. Good job, Alfie.
Wow. Our little one woke up earlier than we thought, our little one being Stella. So we're hustling so we don't have to make her wait upstairs for too much longer. And the kit come through the kitchen. Happy birthday! Happy birthday, 8-year-old! Yay! Look at you. You look a little taller today. You definitely look older.
There is a moment meant for us, and now you made it, but I already played this, not interested. Open your eyes, let's get it done. Take my hand, just follow me.
Thank you so much, Mommy. This is so fun.
You're welcome, my 8-year-old. I love you. We'll do anything for you. Anything.
It feels weird that I'm 8.
You do feel weird. You feel like, feel different, like an 8-year-old.
Shadowing me, I want.
Am I taller? Yeah.
Your mommy and daddy show you how it's done. Oh, I'll never get tired. Just wanna dance. Just wanna run.
Oh, yeah.
Don't know.
I've known them yet, okay. And how are you?
Good, all good. Yep.
Yeah, good. Can I give up? Yeah, we're okay. Just
you're soon to be 8, Willem.
You're almost 8.
Ready, Peter?
Oh, I'm in the photo.
Willem, we miss you.
Wait, no.
I miss you too.
We can't wait for you guys to visit. So I made this caramel cake. I was going to make her a candy cake, and I asked her last night what she wanted, and she said a caramel cake. I thought, oh, I want to make her the cake she wants. So I changed plans, and I made a caramel cake.
Wait.
But then this morning when I reminded her, I said I was going to make you a candy cake. She was like, oh, I wish I had a candy cake. She's like, it's okay. She always does that. But I just can't. I can't not make her the cake she wants. So I'm pushing off the caramel icing.
Why do we still remember that kid?
And that big chubby boy that jumped on me.
Yeah. I still remember what color shirt he was wearing.
Yeah, yellow.
I miss you. We haven't seen moms. Just wanna dance. Just wanna
run. Holy cow, Stella, that is quite the birthday thing.
Stella, that is an awesome cake and decoration.
Thank you.
Oh my word.
That's amazing.
Hi. Uncle Chris, I just see your head on the mountain.
Bye, Grant.
Happy birthday, Stella.
Happy birthday, Stella.
Hi, Kayla. Evan, we see you looking away from us right now.
All right.
To you, happy birthday, dear Stella. Happy birthday to you.
I'm over here, gotta get across. Whether you like it or not, there is a moment meant for us.
Oh, the caramel.
And now you made it, but I already played this.
Really
not
it's,
interested.
Yeah, it's
open your eyes, let's get it done. Yeah, take my hand, just follow me.
It's named Stop Motion. Wee.
Poor Alfie couldn't last, and he fell asleep on the sofa. He missed the Zoom call with my family and the happy birthday. And I keep saying, Stella, you need to wait for him to wake up to open up the gift. You know what? It is your birthday, so
yes.
Let's do it.
It's a skateboard!
Yes!
The shadow and me are one. Oh, the sky is on fire. The lake has turned to a golden sun.
Grandpa, Grandma Wada gave you money to go shopping with.
Go online shopping.
Yeah.
Because we can't leave our house, unfortunately.
Our plan before the lockdown was for Stella and I to go to one of our local hotel that's by the Thames. Mm-hmm. Quite charming. We were going to have one night of a staycation there for her birthday. But of course we couldn't do it because lockdown meant that all hotels and hospitality had to close. And she was really bummed about that. We thought we would try to create a staycation inside our own home. Stella and I are going to spend the night in a hotel. In fact, we're staying at a really swanky 5-star hotel. You may have heard of it. It's called the Johnson Marais. If you haven't been watching the vlogs, that is a hotel that Alfie designed and built. It's one of the world's best and most impressive hotels, and we get to stay there tonight. Stella has her bag packed. I need to pack mine, but we're gonna go check into our room at the Johnson Marais.
Oh, yeah.
You excited to go to the Johnson Marais?
Yeah. This is one of my old packs. I don't use it anymore. It's like from like 5 years ago.
We're room number 30.
Oh, here it is.
Okay, let me just use the card.
Doo-doo.
It smells so nice.
Wow. Thank you, Daddy.
Daddy, your hospitality father.
It smells so nice.
But there's a room service menu. And then we can hang this on the door. The toiletries.
Sewing kit.
Yeah.
Shoe maker.
The bathroom's pretty nice.
We have a toothbrush.
Good.
Okay.
Okay. Awesome. Stella. Stella. Sweet. Oh, you have a letter. Who's that from?
Bananas! Dear Stella, wishing you a very happy 8th birthday and a warm welcome to the Johnson Marais Hotel. We are so happy that you celebrate with us and wish you a wonderful stay. Alfred
Davies, the general manager.
Please welcome to hotel. Why are you holding a banana, mister?
This is really special. The general manager of the Johnson Marais has sent you a letter and he's here to greet you as well. Stella, the general manager of the Johnson Marais wants to dance with me.
Hey. Mom, look at the sun!
Yeah!
How did Daddy learn? Daddy?
YouTube. Sorry.
Four years at hotel school, sorry.
Did he ask?
YouTube.
Mom, he broke it! The manager broke it! Why not poke to be an hotel?
Oh, he's made a policy change on the spot. We've had turn down service already because it is kind of late, but let's order some room service. Come on.
Let's order some room service.
Hello?
Oh, the GM is getting in here with us. Okay, guys, let's look at the room service menu for the Johnson Murray Hotels. Oh, breakfast from 7:45 to 8:30. You can have coffee,
wait,
cordial,
breakfast?
Egg white omelet, bagel with biscuit, kippers, kitchery, and Brits. This is very swanky.
What about for dinner?
Oh, I already looked at the dinner menu, but I already ordered room service. It's coming soon, so I ordered us burgers because I know you wanted burgers for your birthday. I ordered curly fries and crinkle fries.
Oh, the manager, the Johnson Murray, is dancing.
I will dance with you. Oh. He's flirting with me.
He is flirting with me.
So romantic. So romantic. Oh no, now they're kissing.
Do you like this?
I love it, Mom. Mom, of course I love it.
Oh, please get the door ourselves.
Hello.
Hello, Miss Davis. You. Did you order some food?
Hello. Yes, I did. I'm Hello. Alfie Davies.
Yeah, Alfie Davies, of course you are, Miss Davies. Sorry. Where would you like me to place the food?
You can place the food
right there.
Be over here on this table.
Yeah, right over there.
Thank you. Be careful.
You can sit around.
I told them to do that. That was my request.
Because people do that.
Oh, because that's my favorite thing about room service.
So, we have some waters here for you.
Thank you.
The cheeseburger.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Miss Davies. I didn't realise you were joining them to dine. I'll bring down yours in just a moment. And a gluten-free bun, I believe, ma'am. Is that correct?
Yeah. Thank you, Johnson Murray Hotels, for accommodating.
Is this your first visit to the hotel?
Yes.
Oh, wonderful. Well, I see that you're in a deluxe country view room, so tomorrow morning you'll have a delightful view of the countryside, hopefully if the weather's good. Are you any plans whilst you're here? Are you George Michael fans? You are, I thought that's what you were here for, so obviously you can go down there and check that out. Curly fries, some crinkle fries.
The general manager is upset that you forgot Cheeky.
I'll get some for Cheeky, Mr. Davis. Would you like me to come and collect the tray, your tray afterwards?
Yes, please. We'll be done in about an hour.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
And just don't forget to order your breakfast in the morning. Excellent. Thank you so much. Is there anything else more I can bring you?
Yes. I need to be discreet about this, but...
I want a normal bagel with cream cheese.
Oh.
Mr.
Davies, the GM... he may need to have his diaper changed.
Certainly, not the first time. We're quite used to this scenario. Thank you for telling us.
I want cordial, but Cheeky will have water.
Okay, let's go. We just need to change about. Mr. Davies. I think it's best for the chat. No. Thank you. Enjoy your meal. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
This is so fun. I've been really wanting...
It's very good service.
Yeah, very good service. They have a reputation for really good service.
Yeah, yeah. And they celebrate birthdays really well.
They do.
Mmm.
Good. Compliments to the chef. Wink, wink. No, we should watch pay-per-view tonight. A pay-per-view movie.
Oh, I kind of wanted to watch SpongeBob.
Okay.
The new SpongeBob.
It's probably on pay-per-view.
No, it's on Netflix.
Pay-per-view is what you watch in hotels, where you, rent a movie on. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's probably on pay-per-view.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Davies, the GM, is back, and he's having some dinner with us.
he just came in. He just opened the door without even asking us and came in and took a ride.
The GM is jumping on our bed. This is very unconventional.
I'm hungry. Thanks.
I'm exercising.
Oh, all the employees are eating with us.
Dad, you're supposed to be the food guy.
I know, you're the general manager.
Oh, the general manager just ate a little nibble of the chocolate.
Well, it's a good thing the mini bar's locked.
The GM just came in nibbling on a doll's toes.
I think this guy's a little psychopath.
It's a little off.
I will be in here tonight. Don't laugh, guys.
Where are you gonna sleep?
With you guys.
In your bed.
Until morning. Room for eight is ready.
I think that love that I found you.
Can the managers go live somewhere else? <He's> like,
Aww, he's trying to dance with you. That's sweet. Here she is. We are now having movie night at our hotel at the Johnson Marais. And Stella is putting the shoemet on her slippers. What movie are we watching?
The new SpongeBob.
My little girl. A small town by the name of Bikini Bottom. Stella, come in. It's room service.
Oh, good morning. Good morning. Good morning. As your room service was ordered, Miss Davies? You wanted cordial and Biscoff coffee.
Thank you.